Hello students, myself Manjula Sheshgiri. How are you all? Hope you all are doing good. Stay home and stay safe. Okay, now we have started online classes. Whenever you get free time, you can read not only the textbook, the other books also you can read. Don't waste your time unnecessarily in watching movie or chit-chatting some other things. Right. Okay, I am handling the first unit in your paper, that is called clinical nutrition. The name of the paper is clinical nutrition. In that I am taking the first unit, that is having a two parts. The part A is it's about role of nutrition in community's health and national development, and the part B is nutritional status. Let us start with the nutritional status. After this, it will be very easy for you people to understand the role of nutrition in community's health and nutritional or national development. Okay. Before going to the nutritional status, one has to know about the meaning of nutrition. What is this nutrition? What do you know about nutrition? Nutrition, it is the science of foods, the nutrients and other substances therein, their action, interaction and balance in relationship to health and diseases. Means it is the action and interaction of the nutrients and other substances which are there in the food in keeping our body in the balance with relation to the health. That is the meaning of the nutrition. In detail, if we say it is the process by which the organism ingest, means we usually eat the food, no? We ingest, digest, absorbs, transports and utilizes the nutrients and disposes, or you can say the excretion of their end products. In addition, nutrition is concerned with social, economical, cultural and psychological implications of the food and eating. So here the simple thing is, whatever we eat, how our body get digest that food, how the nutrients get absorbed, how much nutrients get absorbed, how much is transported and utilized, the nutrients which are there in the food to keep our body, and how the excretion process takes place, whether it is in the proper way or not. All this process, if it is good, then we can assess the nutritional status. So nutrition means this. In short, nutrition science is the area of knowledge regarding the role of food in the maintenance of health. Okay, next, nutrition status. So if the nutrition is in the good form, that means the nutritional status is good, like that. So what is this nutritional status? It is the condition of health of an individual as influenced by the utilization of nutrients. Means whatever we eat, no, how and how much the nutrients are utilized by our body, whether the all nutrients whatever we have ate, whether all those nutrients are utilized in the adequate amount or not. So that is the nutritional status. It can be determined only by the correlation of information obtained through a careful medical and dietary history, a thorough physical examination and appropriate laboratory investigation. Means how this nutritional status can be determined. It can be determined by the correlation of information what we obtained from the careful medical and dietary history, a thorough physical examination and appropriate laboratory investigation. So nutritional status is the current body status. It is the current. What is it now? Current. It is the current body status of a person or population group which is related to their state of nourishment. That means the consumption and utilization of nutrients. An ideal nutritional status. Ideal nutritional status, it occurs when the supply of nutrients conforms to the nutritional requirements or needs. It means if the supply of nutrients, if all the nutrients are absorbed adequately as the nutrients required by the person, means whatever, if for example if 40 milligrams of vitamin C is required and all 40 milligrams of vitamin C is utilized, means that is good. Like that only it is there for all the nutrients. That is an ideal nutritional status. Then what is the purpose of nutritional assessment? One has to assess the nutritional status. What is the purpose or what is the need? So it is to identify individual or population group at risk of becoming malnourished. ಅವ್ರು ಏನಾದರೂ ಮಾಲ್ ನರಿಶ್ಡ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರಾ ಅಂತ ನೋಡೋಕ್ಕೆ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಸೆಸ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಷನಲ್ ಅಸೆಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಅನದರ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಅ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ಮಾಲ್ ನರಿಶ್ಡ್. ಇಫ್ ದ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಪಾಪ್ಯುಲೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಮಾಲ್ ನರಿಶ್ಡ್, ಬೈ ಅಸೆಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ನ್ಯೂಟ್ರಿಷನಲ್ ಸ್ಟೇಟಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ದೆಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಅದರ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಅದರ್ ನೀಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಟು ಡೆವಲಪ್ healthcare programs that meet the community needs which are defined by assessment. If we assess that the community or the individual nutritional status is very poor, then one can develop the healthcare programs. So for that purpose also it is very much necessary for assessing the nutritional assessment. And then to measure the effectiveness of nutritional programs and intervention once initiated, if they found that the nutritional status of the population or the individual is very poor, the government may establish or implement some programs, nutritional programs. As we see the ICDS, under ICDS scheme, the food is given to pregnant lactating mothers and even the children, to the children who are in the age of 0 to 6 years, and also it is providing some interventions like vitamin A prophylaxis program that is medicated. Okay, like that we can assess, we can see the effectiveness of those programs in the population or in the individual. For that purpose it is very much necessary for assessing the nutritional status. And what are the methods of assessing the nutritional status? We saw that it is very much necessary or the need of the nutritional assessment. Then what are the methods? How can we assess the nutritional status? That is by two methods. One is direct method and another one is indirect method. In this only the many methods will come. So what this direct method? The direct methods, they deal with the individual and measures the objective criteria. Here in the direct method, we can deal with the only individuals. By individually we can do. Whereas in the indirect methods, we can use the community indices that reflects the community nutritional status. Means we can assess to particular community. So by doing community level, we can assess the, by do, taking the community indices, so it will say the community nutritional status. Okay. First, we'll discuss about the direct methods. Under direct methods, there are four methods by which we can assess one's nutritional status. Those are anthropometry, by clinical assessment, biochemical estimation, and the other one is diet survey. We'll discuss these in detail one by one. Let us start with the anthropometry. What is this anthropometry? Anthropos means man and metron means measurement. A branch of anthropology that involves the quantitative measurement of the human body. Means here it involves only the quantitative measurement of the human body. What is this nutritional anthropometry? Nutritional anthropometry, measurement of the variations of the physical dimensions and the gross composition of the human body at different age levels and degrees of nutrition, which is given by the jellyfish. So usually this anthropometry, it is used to evaluate both undernutrition and overnutrition. And the measured values, they reflects the current nutritional status and don't differentiate between acute and chronic changes. They only reflects or they only says about the current nutritional status, not differentiate between the acute changes or the chronic changes. What is the significance of anthropometry? What is the importance of doing the anthropometric measurements? What is the importance of assessing the nutritional status by anthropometry? That is primary measures of past or current nutritional status in the children. Okay, we can distinguish between stunting and wasting. This will be discussing later, what is stunting and what is wasting, that we can assess by taking the height and weight. Okay, and identify the protein energy malnutrition and obesity. We can monitor changes after nutrition intervention. In clinical settings, can identify the hospital patients with CED or overnutrition, and also it will be helpful in screening the public health. This nutritional anthropometry has both advantages and disadvantages. Let us see what are the advantages. It is simple and safe procedure. It is inexpensive, portable, durable equipments. Means the whatever equipments we use for taking the anthropometer, that is portable. So, and little training is required for this. Precise and accurate methods. Information generated on past long time nutritional history, and it's not possible with other techniques with equal confidence. And on the other hand, to say about the disadvantages, relatively insensitive methods and can't detect disturbances in nutritional status over short period of a time or identify specific nutrient deficiency. By anthropometry, we can't identify that this person is deficient, has a deficiency in the particular nutrient. That we can't identify. That is a disadvantage. And unable to distinguish disturbances in growth or body composition, which is induced by the nutrient deficiency, from those which are caused by imbalances in protein and energy intake. The same. Okay, then these are the disadvantages. Okay, now we'll move on to what are the nutritional anthropometry. In anthropometry means what all the measurements we take. Mainly the measurements what we take in the anthropometer is weight, height, MUAC and FFT. Weight, it is the total body mass. It's simple and widely used. Sensitive to small changes in nutrition. And the height, genetically determined, environmentally influenced. Stunting reflects chronic undernutrition. MUAC, it is nothing but mid upper arm circumference. It reflects the muscle fat or muscle or the fat. It is easy to measure, used for quick screening, independent of age, that is 1 to 5 years. FFT means here fat full thickness. It measures about body fat and correlates well with total body fat. Anthropometric measurements is different for the newborn and the young children and for the adults. Means some anthropometry measurements we do only for the young children and newborn. So those are weight and height. Of course, it is common in both. For newborn and the young children, the anthropometric measurements what we do is weight, recumbent length, head circumference, chest circumference, and mid upper arm circumference. Whereas for the adults, we do weight, height, mid upper arm circumference, waist circumference, hip circumference, and the fat fold thickness. Usually, these three, waist circumference, hip circumference, and fat fold thickness, we won't do for the children. In fat fold thickness, we usually measure triceps, biceps, supra-iliac and subscapular measurements. Okay, then what are the requirements for nutritional anthropometry? If we want to do anthropometric measurements, then what are the requirements? The requirements are as follows. One is the standard equipment. We need the standard equipment. If we are doing the height measurements meets, we have the height rod or whatever through which we measure the height. If we are taking the weight measurements, the weighing equipments we require. Like that, the standard equipments are required, which has the accuracy and consistency. Then appropriate techniques. In that, training and standardization is required. Who is doing the or who is taking the anthropometric measurements, he needs little bit training and he has some standardizations. Correct assessment of age should be there. If age is there, correct assessment of age we do means, then only we can compare that with the standard of the same particular age and sex. Reference values, that is for the comparison and computation of indices, and classification that is required for grading the nutritional status. There are different classifications like water loss classification, Gomez classification. That is, after taking the anthropometric measurements, we put those values into the classifications and we assess how the nutritional status is this. So this is all about the introduction about the nutritional status. In the next section, we learn about in detail the anthropometric measurements like height, weight, mid upper arm circumference, etc. Okay, thank you.